first two sections of this module presented a review of the emergence of interprofessional education, compared IPE with multidisciplinary education, and also presented the desired outcomes of IPE. The support for IPE was presented from the institutional to the international level, and finally, the criteria for full engagement was presented. In this section, the implementation of learner-centered strategies will be discussed along with specific examples of those strategies. The learner-centered teaching strategies in this section will be grouped into domains that were established at the Medical University of South Carolina and was described by Blue et al. In Academic Medicine in August of 2010. The curricular domain addresses IPE within academic programs to ensure that all students have learning and assessment experiences that focus on IPE. The extracurricular domain encompasses strategies that infuse IPE into extracurricular activities and organizations, thereby making it an integral part of students' overall educational experience. The faculty development domain ensures that there is ongoing support for faculty in the development of their understanding of IPE and strengthening their skills and abilities in designing and offering IPE offerings. The healthcare clinicals / simulation domain coordinates clinical learning activities and simulation activities with classroom or didactic curricular learning activities, enabling us to utilize those rich learning environments. True IPE is more than learning side by side. It is, in fact, learning about and with each other. To achieve this fundamental goal, interaction between professions must be facilitated and encouraged. We know from adult learning principles that using a variety of learning methodologies is essential, but these methodologies must include interaction between the participants. Case study discussions and problem-based learning activities are excellent strategies to use. Electronic learning, such as video conferencing, can also be utilized and is very effective when combined with case studies or the problem-based learning activities. Interactive web-based strategies, such as the example in this short video clip, can be used as a preparatory assignment for a problem-based learning activity. Although this particular activity may not involve direct interaction between professionals, it provides baseline information that will promote collaboration during a case study. The web-based modules that require active student involvement are most effective. In order for interprofessional groups to work together effectively, participants must trust others within the group. Trust can be built by incorporating some specific strategies. One such strategy is providing opportunities for sharing profession-specific information. Participants can interview each other to discover such things as educational preparation required for the profession, including prerequisites for admission to a professional program, professional journey of the individual, and even the roles and responsibilities of the profession, and perhaps what contributions that profession makes to a healthcare team. The specific strategy described described on this slide is an effective way to establish common ground among varied professions. This exercise helps each participant realize that each profession brings specialized knowledge and contributions to a patient care scenario. It may also emphasize that although there are similarities among the professions, each fills a specific role in the healthcare team, and that effective teamwork is dependent on collaboration and not competition between the professions. This particular IPE strategy can elicit both positive and negative assumptions about professions. In doing so, it stimulates lively discussions among participants. By revisiting these assumptions at the end of the planned activity, most participants acknowledge both a change in their perceptions of other professions and a recognition of the value of the contributions of other professions to the healthcare team. Trust among the IP group can be strengthened by establishing stability within the group. The strategy presented here requires tremendous planning and creative scheduling in order to keep the same participants together over time. However, starting with basic cases and students in pairs not only builds trust within the group, but also builds self-confidence in each individual participant. As the learning strategy becomes more complex over time, involving more participants, the group works together much more effectively. To establish the importance of interprofessional education and ultimately interprofessional practice, IPE activities must be incorporated into not only curriculum, but also service projects, student activities, and other aspects of student life. Faculty must step up and take action to make these extracurricular activities happen for students. Please visit the website presented on this slide to read about an excellent example of a student-led effort to make interprofessional activities a part of their lives. Providing expert facilitation will make the efforts in IPE successful. It is essential that faculty with essential skills are recruited. Essential skills include facilitation of small group learning, conflict management, and firsthand knowledge of health professionals' relationships. Those facilitators who are most effective fully embrace interprofessional education. Faculty must be supported in order to provide effective interprofessional education. Ongoing training, focus groups, and discussions among faculty must be offered to those faculty that are engaged in IPE efforts.